Welcome, welcome one and all to another episode of Homework. I am Mike Diamond.
And I am Candy Matinga.
Yes, you are. Sweet as can be. We've got a fishbowl full of topics, and we are going to school the kids.
Let's school those kids. Hell yeah.
Playing dress up. Okay, masking, cross-dressing, leather gear, and cosplay.
Masking, cross-dressing,
so I think
leather gear and dress-up.
Femme masking. Like
femme masking. Right, right.
So ooh, this is about putting on
something else to achieve something else.
Yes. Come on, girl. That's what it is.
So this is...
You laugh boldly at me.
This is indeed about putting on something else to look like something else.
To look like something else, okay. Children.
So this is about putting on a show, putting on a costume.
Doing shows, daughter.
I believe it was the late transsexual RuPaul who said,
yes,
you're born naked and everything else is drag.
Everything else is drag. So in a way, I guess we're all doing shows. I just want to preface it all by saying I approve of doing shows. I've been known to do a show.
By all means.
And a couple of those things, such as cosplay and leather, I happen to be very attracted to.
Leather and fetish gear.
Leather, fetish gear, and cosplay.
Yeah.
Like, I'll dress up like Sailor Moon and hit the Comic-Con.
Yeah, and fall into a dip.
And fall into a dip.
So cross-dressing is transvestites, drag queens, perpetrators like that. Right. Not perpetrators.
People, but people doing their thing.
Yeah, people doing their thing. So what is femme masking?
Femme masking has just really sort of come into my frame of reference, strangely enough, as out
as
there.
As you're femme masking right now.
Trust, exactly. I'm always femme masking. Femme masking.
Yes.
And femme masking is this phenomena, I don't know if it's new or not, where men... like literally wear full on other skins,
right?
To look like dolls,
right?
To look like
rubber dolls,
beautiful, I guess to them, beautiful dolls,
right? Beautiful rubber dolls.
Yeah,
I don't get it. I'm not judging it. Like, don't do it. Do it. I don't understand the thrill.
I don't understand. First of all, I just keep on thinking, God, I'd be so hot. I'm always sweating anyway.
Roasting.
You're just going to be roasting. And then also the masks that I've seen, some of them have really, really sort of pretty Cupid doll faces.
And they usually have a nice wig.
Yes, and a pretty wig, a very cinched waist. They're going for that very female silhouette. But the eyes are doll eyes, and they're very dead.
They're flat.
They're very flat.
That's the scary part.
And I find it slightly scary. Like,
because what are you relating to when you look at them?
Right. Well, you know, the eyes are the window to a person's soul. And
yeah.
Also, the eyes will let you know is someone...
My windows are broken.
So I find them kind of unnerving. And I don't think... Is this something sexual, or is this just dress up? Or
the only thing that makes me think femme masking does have like an erotic... element to it is that, unlike drag, those femme skins, they come with like breasts with nipples.
That's
and
right.
A full set of genitalia. Like, I don't know. I'm sure there are some people that do it for their erotic thrills, but I get the sense that for them, it's more like being a furry, where they're sort of like taking on this other identity.
Right, right. Which I think is a little bit different from a leather queen.
I've seen some furry leather queens.
Yes, but yeah. I'm not sure if they're taking on a completely different identity. The thing about furries is, I don't know, I find the whole furry phenomenon...
Another sweaty endeavor.
Yeah, like that one, I find there's a little whimsy to that, and so I find it sort of funny. Like, would I ever yiff with someone? I think it unlikely, but it's not out of the question.
No, certainly not, darling.
Because I am a freak.
Somebody came up in a really good wildebeest outfit.
Trust my new drag name, Miss Wilda Beast. Miss Nilda Beast.
Furries are the ones that dress in furry costumes. Plushies
right.
are the ones that have sex with stuffed animals.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Okay. I feel like there's just too many things, girl.
There's so many things, girl, out there. Lots of things, girl.
And I'm not judging. I'm not judging.
And
I just,
you know, I like things. I like to do things.
I can't multitask.
I like to do things. Like, I like the puppy play. I do.
Yeah.
Listen, a man wearing a, you know,
a Batman costume.
A Batman costume and wearing like a little dildo in his ass with a ball that has a tail standing out. Sexy for me, girl.
Listen, if you enjoy dressing up as a rubber doll and putting on your femme skin and going out and masquerading, fantastic.
Absolutely.
What about cosplay. And we don't mean Bill Cosby, where you wear an ugly sweater.
That's right, where you wear an ugly sweater and have sex with an old man.
Yeah, bathed in Jell-O pudding pops.
I did cosplay. I love to dress as a comic book character and hit Comic-Con.
Comic-Con be giving you some stanky experience. That is too many ripe bitches in too tight a space.
You know, that
and the costumes make it worse.
Yo,
that have you had your sprinkle today?
It feels like home to me.
Wait a minute. Are you telling me that you did not find Comic-Con to be an overly fragrant affair?
Was it fragrant? I didn't notice it to be fragrant.
Oh,
no.
My God.
I did not notice Google it to be fragrant.
Google it, kids. Comic-Con smells. It does. I had a good time. I stepped in the giant oversized Star Wars action figure display.
Oh, trust.
But it smelled.
But, you know, yeah, so if you want to dress up, and I'm not sure if there's such thing as erotic cosplay, but it's certainly possible.
God, of course there is.
Is there really? I guess there
That's
is.
That's all the bitches dressed like Catwoman. Come on.
Right. Go on with your bad self. I may join you in a minute.
There's a whole subset of guys that do that where they dress up like in, you know, tight superhero clothes and get together. Miss
no.
Thing.
Really? I mean, I've heard of the latex, well, like the rubber man sort of thing.
This is the whole thing where they kind of dress up like in those shiny, like Power Ranger kind of costumes.
Really?
And it's a sexual thing.
Skin tight on Miss Matinga can not necessarily be the greatest thing. Could make me look like Baby Huey, possibly.
Why do people put on shows? Why do people put on these identities, these externals? These additions to the home.
Because it makes them feel good. It makes them feel sexy. It turns them on, or maybe it just.
Or they want attention.
And
or they're feeling funky that day.
Yeah, and all those things are valid.
I think if you're into it and it's your thing, do your thing. If it's consensual, I don't care.
I think we should also lightly touch upon transvestism, which we've talked about before.
I think we have lightly touched upon transvestism, dear.
Oh, yes. Oh, no, not even that. Full dragas.
Yeah, full dragas. Full dragas. Up in the jags. Like, femme masking is a sort of transvestism, cross-dressing, because it's straight guys putting on female attire. And
it is. It seems like another step in that direction. I also sort of feel like, dudes, you want to be a pretty woman? How about we just learn proper shading and makeup technique and buy a really nice wig? Listen, if they can make Oprah as lovely as she looks on camera.
She want to talk about a wildebeest.
Honey. So rubber dolls, cosplay, motherfucking dressing up, transvestism, whatever the children are feeling.
Puppy tails. Pippi Longstocking.
Go on with your bad selves. We live, we love, we celebrate the differences. This is homework.